morning, student. Welcome back to your science class. And the topic is cellular respiration. Previous class, I have given the respiratory organs name and their function. And I have given the picture also how respiratory gas comes from the outside to inside the lungs. Okay, so today we will discuss about the cellular respiration and also hemoglobin. Okay, and how pure blood and impure blood move and circulates in the body with the help of the blood. So today only we will discuss. Okay, so start from cellular respiration. Respiration I have given. Okay, the breakdown of the food, the breakdown of the food to produce energy and release carbon dioxide gas and also release a lot of energy in a form of the ATP. So this kind of the procedure takes place in the side of the cell. And if inside of the cell, it means this kind of procedure is called a cellular respiration. Respiration takes place inside the cell is called a cellular respiration. Okay, and the most important thing, respiratory pigment name. And the respiratory pigment name is hemoglobin. I mentioned hemoglobin, and hemoglobin symbolized by the capital H small b. Hemoglobin, write it. Hemoglobin is a respiratory pigment. What it is? A respiratory pigment. So respiratory pigment has a heme pigment and globulin protein. Okay, and globulin protein, heme pigment, globulin protein. Heme provide a red color. Heme provide a red color to the blood cells. Okay, if red color blood cell, it means the erythrocyte or RBCs. RBCs. So only RBCs has a hemoglobin pigment, and that's why the blood cell color is red. And RBCs is also called a erythrocyte. Cyte means cell, erythro means red. Red color cell. Okay, this much is clear. So, next one. Is it clear what is hemoglobin? Hemoglobin is according to your standard of class. Hemoglobin definition, this much only I've read. Hemoglobin is a respiratory pigment and it has a heme pigment and globulin protein. And heme pigment provide a red color to the cell and globulin protein provide the protection against the pathogen and help for the growth of the and development of the repairing of the cell. Now clear? Okay. So when hemoglobin, only RBC is having a hemoglobin. So hemoglobin react in the blood cell, in the RBCs, in the erythrocyte. When hemoglobin react with oxygen, then it will produce inside the blood oxyhemoglobin. And oxyhemoglobin indicate the purified form of the blood. Okay, when oxygen react with hemoglobin inside the lungs, then it will convert into the pure blood, is called oxyhemoglobin. It means oxygen gas quantity is more than in compared to the carbon dioxide gas. Very less amount of carbon dioxide is there. That's why the presence of oxygen is more and is called a pure blood. Okay, and the second one, when hemoglobin react with the carbon dioxide, then it will produce a carbaminohemoglobin. Carbaminohemoglobin, CO2HB. Carbaminohemoglobin, and in the case of the carbaminohemoglobin, carbon dioxide gas quantity is more in compared to the oxygen gas. That's why it's also called a impure form, deoxygenated form of the blood, impure form. Okay, a deoxygenated blood is also called a carbaminohemoglobin, and this type of blood only form after the reaction between the hemoglobin and carbon dioxide gas. So for today class, this much only student you have to revise. Once again, I want to give the explanation. Cellular respiration, respiration takes place inside of the cells, called a cellular respiration, and respiration done by the help of the respiratory pigment is called a hemoglobin, and hemoglobin only present in the side of the erythrocyte or red blood cell. Red color provided by the heme pigment to the cell. Okay, and that's why hemoglobin is also called a respiratory pigment, and it only, this only hemoglobin only receive the oxygen and carbon dioxide gas. Only hemoglobin, okay, only hemoglobin pigment carries the, receive the respiratory gases. That's why it's also called a respiratory pigment. If the question, why hemoglobin is also called a respiratory pigment, just because of this one character, because this one only receive the respiratory gas, that's why the is also called a respiratory pigment. So student, please revise it. Okay. In the next class, we will discuss about the next topic. Thank you and have a nice day.